Welcome to the Olympic Shooting Range. I hope you are enjoying our coverage here in Cyprus. Remember, of course, we have our last final coming up. The weather, well, the clouds are rolling over. It's a little dark, if truth be told, but the wind seems to have died down a little bit after the gusts we were seeing in the women's final. We have eight men who are ready to rock and roll, and well, let's see who's going to take the title. Lucy Hall, of course, of Great Britain, taking the gold. It is, well, I find it hard to believe it's 19 degrees. I've got my two coats on, but I suppose I'm sitting not getting any exercise at all and feeling the cold. But the gusts have died down. The wind has turned around. It seems to be coming over the left shoulder of the athletes. And that is the scene for our World Cup. Not quite as sunny as it might have been. It certainly was lovely this morning. It's just clouded over, and as Lucy Hall was saying, didn't it change during the women's final? Pedros is ready. The technical director for the Cyprus Shooting Federation, the competition manager for this World Cup, and he is welcoming our athletes. First up, Alicia Salbayev, the 21-year-old from Kazakhstan. Best was in Doha a while ago this year, 29th. Well, big reception for Andreas Makri of Cyprus. He does have a World Cup gold, but you've got to go back to Chang Wong in 2019. To Slovakia, Adrian Drobny from Trnava, all medals at team or mixed team events, so a real chance for him to do well on the stage here. He does have a World Championship individual bronze, a junior one from 2015. And the last of the four in the first ranking match, Thomas Pasiewski from Roshlov. Here's a veteran, Anton Glasnevich, the 42-year-old. A couple of individual World Cup goals for him. Abdel Mehelbi, the 34-year-old. Been to two Olympic Games, a couple of times the African champion. And here's another veteran, Giovanni Cernogoraj. He's 40 years of age. The Olympic gold, of course, in London. And then the other British athlete with a chance to emulate Lucy Hall and take a gold. The 26-year-old had a team gold in the World Championship in 22. Also that European Championship bronze in Larnaca in 22 when Lucy Hall also took a medal as well. Christoph Busch is our referee in charge. And our other official is from Cyprus. Managing just to find a bit of space in the lineup. So eight athletes, two ranking matches. A reminder, if you just joined us, as to how this works. If you're new to the sport, it's lovely to have your company. Two relays, two semi-finals in matter of fact. 15 targets, we'll decide fourth. 25 targets, we'll decide third, and who goes through to the medal match. Poland, Slovakia, Cyprus and Kazakhstan. That's our first ranking match here in Larnaca, with some home hope in Andreas Makri, man from Paradimni. I do hope I've said that correctly. Test fires first. I've just looked up Paradimni, make sure it's where it is. It is just up from Ayia Napa, So I guess he's enjoyed a few parties in his time. Just near to the Turkish part of this island. So not a massive commute for him. Though I suspect he's more au fait with the shooting range up in the capital. Pasierbski gets us underway with a hit. Drobny as well. Now then, everyone holds their breath for the start of the campaign for Andreas Macri. Macri does well. Straight down the middle. That'll calm the nerves. It's Albayev of Kazakhstan. All green, first time round. That's our first red. It wasn't the trickiest. Way to the right-hand side, dipping down. Not a problem for Drobny. Now the man from Kazakhstan, again down the middle. He is towering over everybody else. He is a tall man. He is a broad man. A second in a row for Pasierbski. At the moment, lagging behind everybody else. Macri on station five, no problems. The bins have been dispensed with. Too much wind. Need a few lead weights in the bottom of those. So they have been dispensed with, and we will instead just litter the floor. They'll be picked up later on. Another gust comes through. Flags. So to flap the towels to keep your hands dry, also flapping around. Macri, nicely done. Good start from all but Pasierbski. And there's the first red, Albayev. Still enough light for it not to be a problem. The light enhancing glasses are on. And we get to five targets out of the first 15. And at the moment it's disadvantage to the Polish athlete. Pasierbski. He's one behind Albayev, Drobny and Macri, so far yet to miss. Still time to pull it out of the fire. Riser, but not a lot of angle on that one for Macri. Albayev. Again, looking pretty good. Just the one miss from him. It's going to be a tight one, you get a feeling, don't you? I mean, you never know, could be wrong. Drobny. Oh, his medals. As we mentioned, either in team or mixed team events and in senior ranks. What a nice time it would be for the world number 31 to break his duck on the senior circuit. Oh, and that was a miss. Slightly snatched it, a little shake of the head from the big Kazakhstan athlete. Right down the middle for Pasarevsky. Drobny's looked in good nick. Can he get back into something like form? A couple of misses from him. Whatever happens, it's by far the best performance from him. Just 21 years of age, Alicia Isalbayev. And a real prospect, I think. We are off to Kazakhstan later in the World Cup season. The World Championships in all disciplines, rifle and pistol included, in Baku at the back end of the summer. And she's dropping it at the moment. Pasarevsky playing catch up. This the two-thirds mark in terms of who is the first person to go. Macri back on the horse after his miss last time out. Very effective from Isalbayev. Not the smoothest at the shooting position, but certainly effective. Ten targets gone. Drobny yet to drop one. Macri not far behind. Those two in pole position. Pasarevsky is the man with some work to do. Was chasing that one all the time, and that's another miss. No problems for Isalbayev. So it is Pasarevsky, only one behind. There's still time. Still time. Oh, another miss for Drobny, his first of the competition. So it's all tightening up a little bit at the business end. Pasarevsky needs to keep it in the green and just keep an eye on the others. Ooh, and there is a miss. So Drobny, two in a row after being blemishless. And it is getting tight now. Very tight indeed. Two more targets to go before our first athlete leaves. Remember, it is Isalbayev who has the disadvantage in terms of bib number if it comes down to it. Oh, another miss from Drobny. Three in a row. 11 straight and three reds in a row. Oh, I was about to say, the man from Kazakhstan's come roaring back, but then he drops one. So we're all on 11. Trotny was a country mile ahead. But he's not now. Pasiewski topped qualification after a shoot-off with Hales and Drobny. Well, these targets are massively important now. Way to the right. We're all on 12. And then it comes down to the bib number. As we say, Alisha Aysalbayev is the one who has to make way. He qualified in seventh, so had the lowest bib number here. And so qualification is important. It does play a fact in it. And the 21-year-old will play no further part. Well, that really tightened up, didn't it? It could have been anybody. Everyone on 12. But Aysalbayev is the man who is unlucky. And we get underway straight away. Another 10 to decide who will join. Whoever makes it through in the second ranking match in the medal match. Got some big names in match two as well. Anton Glasnovic, Giovanni Chernogorac, Abdel Mahelbi and Nathan Hales. Well, that's a fairly decent lineup, isn't it? Miss from Macri puts him one behind. Started so well, but there are reds littering the scoreboard for him. First date, absolutely no problem at all. Nicely done. Follow that one as it rose. Macri at the disadvantage, but there is still time. He has work to do, but any ties will be decided by shoot-off at this stage to decide which two go through. Tight one, this, enthralling. Most people here who are not a competitor or a team member will be rooting for the home boy, Andreas Macri, 31-year-old. Has tasted success before, would desperately like to do it again, particularly on our home range. At the moment, he is at a disadvantage. Really needs to have a swing of two to give him a chance. Petrovski. Started with two misses out of three, he's missed another one. And that's what Macri would have been saying to himself. Well, if I keep hitting, there's every possibility that there may be a swing. We saw Wu, who was absolutely wonderful and consistent through the middle stages of the competition in the final just a few moments ago, faltering at the end, and Lucy Hall taking advantage. And the Cypriot coach will be hoping that there is an opportunity. Both Pasiewski and Macri on 16. So, Drobny with his nose ahead. Pasiewski, five more targets before We know who goes through. Drobny misses one. Level with Pasiewski. Are we going to be in another situation where everyone is on the same score? Or everyone's on 12 when there were four? This, they would go to a shoot-off. Oh, and a miss. This time from Pasiewski. Hands the advantage back to Drobny. They like that to the home crowd. So it's Pasiewski, who is at the disadvantage at the moment. Will, may, probably will, all change in the next three targets. Snapping to the left to take that one, Tomasz Pasiewski. Man from Roshloff. Looking for his first individual medal, best sixth in Nicosia last year in the snow at some point during that competition. And Macri goes into the lead in the home crowd like that. Someone's living it. Well, from behind to ahead. It only took about five targets each. Pasiewski and Drobny now slugging it out. Each target that's hit by Macri, big cheer goes up, and he's hit the last eight in a row. He had a middle part of this competition where it wasn't going quite so well, but he's back into some form now. Pasiewski hits 20. It could still be 20 for everyone again, couldn't it? Drobny. Is that a miss? No, it's not. Macri to make sure and to keep himself out of the battle to stay in. So Macri has 21, and the other two say thank you, congratulations, well done Andreas, off you go. We've got the small bitters of a shoot-off to get underway. Sudden death, of course. As I understand it, it'll be Pasiewski who will get us underway on that. Just getting some more cartridges, getting themselves ready. Mario Filipovic able to smile. Just another day at the office. Not quite, but it's the chance of a World Cup medal. So then, here we go. So, sudden death, Pasiewski, Drobny, oh no, this could be a very short shoot-off. Well, that would, it's always, they say an advantage to go first, but not if you do that. Adrian Drobny misses as well. Oh well, on we go. Pasiewski, I'm pretty sure, was just in his mind about to shake hands and walk off. Not so quickly. This time he hits. It was a riser. It wasn't the easiest. Drobny has to hit to stay in the competition. And that is a miss. Well, Pasiewski turns around, a little fist bump to his coach and to his team. And well, a bit of drama there when he missed first time. I'm sure he thought that's that. But Drobny has to accept third place. Remember, it's Macri and Pasiewski who will go through and meet whoever it is who will make it through from our next ranking match. Cyprus, Poland, Macri, Pasiewski, it is who go through. Congratulations to them. Ranking match two on its way. Ranking match two then, our second semi-final, so to speak. Great Britain, Croatia, Egypt and Croatia again. Črnogorac, Glasnovic flying the flag for Croatia. Nathan Hales looking to join Lucy Hall on the podium. Top step of the podium. We will see, there's a long way to go before we get there. You're not missing anything, just the sighting test targets at the moment. Hale's second in qualification in a three-way shoot off the top place. It was Pasiewski who just edged Hale's. Adrian Drobny as well in that fight. So Hale's gets us underway. The 26-year-old had the bronze here in the European Championships last year, like Slanica. It was a bit hotter last year, goodness me. Towards the end of the summer, it was broilingly hot during the day and really pleasant in the evening to walk down the promenade of Larnaca. It's a bit breezier, a bit cooler. Get your coat on weather here. And Anton Glasnevich, the 42-year-old, is the first to miss. A couple of individual World Cup goals. Oh, and Hells misses as well. Remember, 15 targets. We'll know who takes the fourth place and doesn't progress. Way to the left, not a problem this time for Glasnevich. His brother Josip was 11th, not for him. A chance to take a fifth World Cup gold. Remember the man who won the gold in Rio. But it's his brother who takes centre stage here at the moment. Helber going well. Chernogorac also going well. There's a bit of brightness and lightness, even though there is dark cloud above, away to our left, where the sun is a little less bright, the cloud. And so it's okay at the moment. Not too shabby, the light, and another miss there. Oh, and the crowd thinks there was a hit. Shotgun referee, the side referee next to me, thumb down. Check out to the other side. I don't think it was the wrong side for him, really. It stays down the thumb. And our referee's getting the bird from the bleachers, who all saw something different. I have to say, I didn't see anything, but it all depends on where you are. That's the view from the top of the cliff, so to speak, where the clubhouse is perched. That definitely is a miss, no doubt about that. Mihelba in the red for the first time. Hales on this far side, the station number 5. Hales there or thereabouts has the advantage of taking the first target of the set. Well, this is a tight one, isn't it, at the moment? Glasnevich, no problems this time. Straight down the middle. Everyone on 4 then. Marco Micheli already celebrated 1 gold for Great Britain. Could there be another medal? Well, Hales has to get through this first. Has the best bib number, of course, which gives him an advantage, certainly, in the battle not to be fourth. I'm going to get across to the right-hand side. Mihelba, the 34-year-old. Inside the top 15, just in the world. Didn't have a bronze in the World Cup at Lenato a couple of years ago. But certainly not the top step of the podium. And another miss for Nathan Hales. Now then, he'll be watching, I'm sure, with slight concern. That's how the others get on. Again, a tricky one away to the right for Chernogratz. Dealt with it very nicely. Down the middle this time for Mihalba. Should be a very simple one for him. Oh, and I think there was definitely a puff of powder from where I was sitting. And, well, the line referee where I was, right in front of me, agreed eventually. Took a while. I think they got the right decision in the end. So it is Hales with a disadvantage at the moment. Took a nibble, just a nibble, but it was enough. Down the middle, more than a nibble from Chernogratz. Could we get two Croatian athletes through in this semi-final? Certainly Glasnevic, Chernogratz, both excellent athletes. Really, reputation precedes them. There's certainly time for it to change around for the left-hander, Hales. Has a World Cup bronze from Tuscan back in 2018, does Hales. Well, there you go. Chernogratz joins him on 7. As the sun comes out over their left shoulder. And it's Glasnevic and Mihalba who have the advantage here. No, oh, no. Not this time. High to the left. Took it early. Didn't get anything on it. That was very quickly taken as well by Chernogratz, who restores a one target advantage over Hales. It's Mihalba and Glasnevic, both on 9. Nathan Hales with a bit of work to do. Ah, and Josip is in the coach's chair. Well, I'm sure he'll feel no need to be gentle with his brother. I'm assuming he's sitting in the chair for his brother. Perhaps he's in the chair for Chernogratz. Anyway, two coaches and two Croatian athletes. And a miss. No. Well, the side referee in front of me put his thumb down initially, looked at the main referee and changed his decision. The officials working together to make sure they are happy with what the outcome is. Dark clouds overhead, a bit of sunshine away to our left. Changeable conditions here. Hales back into a bit of decent form. That's 3 on the trot. And the gold medalist sitting with the rest of the British team. Hoping for a repeat of the women's competition. Lucy Hoare doing great work. Everyone wrapped up well. Not your average, whether you think of when you think of Cyprus, although I was told that a couple of days ago, a local told me, well, no, 10 days time, it'll be summer. 10 days time. Well, we'll all be gone by then, apart from our local hosts. And a miss. First one for a while. For Cheering the Gratz, in fact, for anybody in this competition. Level with Hales again. Mahalba takes advantage. Just the one miss for the Egyptian. Oh, and that looked like a miss from Hales. He couldn't believe it. Head went back straight down the middle. That's not one you are expecting to miss. And the British contingent, hands on heads. No, that could be important. Yeah, there you go. As we get to 15 targets, no coming back from that. It would have been Chernogratz who would have gone had Hales hit that one because of the bib number. Dastanich wraps up the misery for Nathan Hales. Not to be a second gold medal for Great Britain. He goes out at the earliest opportunity in this second ranking match. Despite having qualified top of the pile and only missing out on the number one spot thanks to a shoot-off. So Hales takes his seat. Mahalba, Glasnovic and Chernogratz are still in it. At least one Croatian will be going through to the final. Chernogratz with a little bit of work to make, to do to make that up. There are some very dark clouds, but I think they're not directly above us. Can't really see. We are in the bus shelter, if you like to call it. Call what you want. We're very happy to be here, just in case it does rain. Some of my colleagues are on a table just adjacent, but outside. Nice in the sunshine, not so nice when it rains. Here we go then. Who will have to drop out and take third place? Another 10 targets. And then we will know. 10 targets per athlete, of course. That makes make clear that. Three left. Remember, already had our first ranking match. If you've just joined us, where have you been? We've missed you. Thomas Pasiewski of Poland, Andreas Makry of Cyprus have made it through. And a chance for two Croatians perhaps to make it through. But Mahalba has other ideas. The Egyptian still in his prime at 34. Looking to make it the third Olympic Games in Paris. Seconds, of course, on the clock. These athletes, as soon as they get themselves ready, clock starts ticking. Normally got 4 or 5 seconds before you get yourself the shot away. And Mahalba, his first ready in quite some time. It's his second overall. Still in a decent place, but Chernogratz is lurking. There is still time for this to turn around. Albert under pressure, but he's in good form despite the previous miss. The mixed trap competition tomorrow, not live, but you are able to keep up with that on the IWSF social media and the website. Low to the left, the Egyptian, no problem at all. Flanked by Croatians, left and right. But he's holding his own. Five more targets to go. Down to business then we go. That's five. Melba needs to keep his nose clean here. Tricky target, rising to the left, but he manages to nab it. Keeps himself ahead of Giovanni Giunigrat. But we saw in the last ranking match, it can all change very quickly. Oh, no. Rather snatched at that one. Took a while to pick up the trajectory. That's a Mahelba. Glasnovic, one ahead of Giunigrat. Yeah, the Cypriot flag is ready for the final. And for Andreas Makri, but they're going to have to wait just a little bit longer. We need to know who will be making their way from the semi-final through to the final. Just starting to run out of targets and time here. Certainly needs to be on it now. Station five in splendid isolation. Oh, that was a brute, absolute brute, wide and high. And that might be it. That might be it. Mahelba through. And Glasnevich will go through as well. Giunigrat, that was a horrible target to get when you need to get yourself in the green. And you finish in style. Glasnevich. And Mahelba with just the two misses so far, and they are ahead, and they will go through. It might be a question of who goes through on top, and Glasnovic with a chance to make life simple for us. Yeah, they both miss, but they're both through. Mahelba, it is. Who goes through, and Anton Glasnovic. It's Giunigrat and Hells who have missed out. Mahelba and Glasnovic take the honours here, and it will be them up against Makri and Pasierbsk of Poland That's the final, and that is coming up in a few minutes' time. We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back for the medal match in trap men individual event of the ISSF World Cup in Shotgun here in Larnaca for 2023. Let's give a warm welcome to the four finalists. With team number four, representing Poland, Tomasz Pasiewski.
So then, time for the medal match in the men's Shotgun World Cup here in Larnaca. Four have made it through from the semi-finals, Tomasz Pasiewski being one of them.
With team number three, representing Cyprus, Andreas Makri.
He got a polite round of applause. This man will get a cheer. Andreas Makri, the 31-year-old from Paradimni up near Ayia Napa. World Cup gold in Changwon 4 years ago. A chance for another one here. Here's a man with a lot of experience. Anton Glasnovic, 42 years of age now, man from Zagreb. He likes table tennis, but he likes shooting a lot more. And Abdel Mahelba, who came through that second semi-final. Those are the four that will look to be on the podium. Only one will miss out. There's our jury member in charge from Iran. Little glimpse of the range dog in the background.
The referee for this medal match, Mr. Christophe Busch from France.
And there's Sir Christophe Busch. The range dog decided to sit with the officials for a while. I wonder probably why everyone's just left him or her.
The medal match begins.
Medal match consists of 15 targets for round one for the first elimination.
So the medal match, four left in our last action live here. Remember, there is the mixed team competition tomorrow. Everyone heading home after that. Mihelba, Glazovic, Makri, Pasiewski, Egypt, Croatia, Cyprus and Poland. We are ready to get underway. Remember, 15 targets will decide who takes fourth. That's decided if there's a tie on bib number. Then another 10 targets for bronze, another 10 targets take gold and silver. Here we go then. The conditions have eased slightly. The wind has dropped. And we have a serene start as well. Mihelba, Glazovic, Makri in the green. Pasiewski of Poland now. A man from Roshlov, where they have a very nice range there as well. Enjoy being there for the European Championships. Rifle and pistol. I flew directly from Cyprus, actually, after the European Championships in shotgun. Didn't have to buy myself a jumper by the time I got there. It was not quite the temperature that it was here in early September. Good start by all here. Down the middle, easy as you like for Pasiewski. Mihelba. Well, what a chance he has here. Man from Alexandria on the north coast of Egypt. Hello, if you're watching at the Alexandra Shooting Club. Your man's doing all right. Makri keeping up with everybody else. Pasiewski with the first miss. Way to the right and slightly snatched at it. Drama for the other three so far. Makri looking to keep up with the Joneses, and no, the flag goes up. Flag goes up. It would be lovely, I'm sure you would agree, for some success for our local athletes. Cyprus with the silver, of course, in this mixed team skeet, even losing out to Germany 6-4. So they already have some silverware, but you can never have too much. Reset and go again for Pasiewski. Just the one miss for him as well. Little look around, just in case the officials didn't see the hit, but they did. Yeah, sixth place, the best. Pasiewski, that was Nicosia last year. Medals in mixed team and team, but lovely those are. You always want to get yourself an individual gong as well. Mihelba gets the next five underway. Glasnevich and Mihelba looking in decent nick at the moment, keeping themselves ahead of Makri and Pasiewski. down the middle now, but we'll be happy with those all day long. Glass stage next up, station three. Again, no drama. Really looked good. Wearing the number one bib, so that's an advantage as well when you're looking to get onto the podium. Fourth place in a tie will be decided by bib number. Oh, and a miss. Second miss in a row for Pasierbski, who is dropping alarmingly away from the rest. Klasnovic and Mihalba at the moment leading the way. Vocal support coming from the Cypriot crowd, who are biting the nails, hoping Macri gets over the line and onto the podium at the very least, and it's looking not bad at the moment. Last target to the first 10, but we've got another five to go. And there is a miss from Glasnovic. Chance for Macri to make up some ground. Did well. Did really well there. And again, of course, puts Pasierbski under pressure down the middle. Not a problem for the Polish athlete. But he still has a bit of work to do with five targets left to decide who takes fourth place. Macri looking okay. Leonatio also in deep conversation, looking relaxed. We start the last five before we lose an athlete with a miss. The first one, a collector's item from Mihalba. Glasnovic, no such worries after missing the one previously. So the two level, Macri also level. Pasierbski with a bit of work to do. He can just keep it in the green, keep his fingers crossed. So that'll be the game plan. He's a wee man, is Macri. Glasnovic towers over him, as does Pasierbski, but it really doesn't matter. Especially when you're in decent form, and he is. He's doing okay, and another miss from Mihalba. Here's Glasnovic and Macri, the chance to overhaul him. Klasnovic does. Macri can do it as well here. Low, not too much of an angle. British coach has made it up to the top by the podium, ready for Lucy Hall's gold medal. We were awaiting news of who will join her in the next ceremony, the men's ceremony. Rahel Wirt back in the green. Hasiewski running out of targets. Not happened for Nathan Hales, watching from afar. Looking very close to making it through, but last miss. And he missed out. It will be Hasiewski who will make way and miss out on the medals. It's always horrible to be just outside, come all this way. Good to see the young lad, I think it's a young lad. Seen him in a very cool little mini hoodie up in the restaurant. Still calm and enjoying the day with mum. Pasiewski finishes with a couple in the green, and so it is the Polish athlete who has to take fourth place. Just misses out on the podium, but he is still all smiles in his best performance in a World Cup individually, overhauling that sixth in Nicosia last year, but still not quite on the podium. 27 years of age, plenty of time. Still get an individual medal. Three left then. The podium sorted, but what will the placings be? Another 10 targets to decide bronze. I hope he will get us underway. Ooh, and a miss from Glasnovic. Well, Macri can take the lead here. And he misses. Way to the right-hand side. It was a tricky one. So all square. Couple of misses from Glasnovic and Macri, making it interesting. Well, everyone's at it now. Mahelba with a miss. Glasnovic back on it. Macri with a chance to keep up with him. Way to the right and smoothly done by the 31-year-old. No, another miss. Two in a row from Mahelba, who was looking such great form. All of a sudden, it's falling away for him. And the locals are making their support known. Around he marches to station number one. Oh, another miss. What is happening to Abdel Mahelba? He was looking in such good form and he is way adrift now. Himself back into the green. Yes, he can. Maybe a little too late. And another red, this time for Glasnevich. Now Macri with a glorious chance to take the advantage. And the crowd love it. He does. He's one ahead. Is it going to be another bronze for Mahelba? That's his World Cup haul so far. He's definitely got another medal coming, but he would desperately like it. And it was looking like it'd be more than a bronze, but he's a couple behind with five targets per athlete left before we drop our bronze medalist back to the seats. And Glasnevic and Macri have it in their hands. Here's Macri. Cheers getting louder and louder. Mixed team Skeet Silver. They've had to cheer that one already. And they will love to see a gold medal for the home nation. You wouldn't put it past them. They love sports shooting here. Mahelba, three out of the last three, but missed the three before that. That's what's really caused the damage for him. Another big cheer. He's not quite safe yet. It will go to Bibb, the bronze medal, if needs be. Mahelba puts a bit more pressure on. A little bit more pressure on Glasnevich than on Macri, even so. Macri can guarantee himself at least a silver here. No, abysses. What a time to miss. Well, first one in seven. And that will make life a little easier for the others. Mahelba will have to settle for bronze. Glasnevich and Macri will slug it out. Ooh, and a miss from Macri, was it? From Mahelba. Yes, it was a second one. As the sun comes out and the light changes, Glasnevich doesn't miss. So a second bronze of his career for Abdelaziz Mahelba. And Glasnevich and Macri will carry on the battle. Well done to Abdel Mahelba. Another bronze in a World Cup final. Well done to him. So two left, gold and silver to be decided in the next 10 targets. Remember, if it's level, at the end of 10 targets, we go to shoot off. If someone's a long way ahead and they can't be caught, we stop with a golden target. So Cyprus have the flag. They have hope. They have their man. Looking good, getting a little extra cartridge into their pockets should this go a long way. Here we go again. 10 more targets, then we'll know. Toe to toe they go. You know, the home crowd are rooting for a little bit of extra pressure perhaps on this man as a result. Down the middle, never a problem. Just on the cusp of 6 o'clock local time, we almost know who's going to take this title. Came out broken, but he hit it, and I think the referee is going to let it go. Certainly wasn't no target. He certainly hit it as well. So yeah, he will have to. There was a cry from side referee of no target. Of course, had the advantage of knowing where it was going. Straight down the middle, no problem. Macri then, pressure on him. Well, I guess the pressure of being the homeboy will either spur you on or weigh you down. It looks like it's spurring him on. Lastovic, yeah, nicely done. Didn't quite nail the cartridge dismount. He fumbled and dropped it. And that's not the important part, is it? Let's be fair. This is going to be a nervy one, isn't it? Who's going to blink first here? Lined up around station one and station two. And it's Glasnevich who'll get us underway. Station one. And he is keeping the pressure on. And Macri is rising to it. Five more targets to go. Both are on 27. Didn't have a gold medal in a World Cup in 22. Did have in 2020 and 21. Will there be a shoot-off? Certainly at the moment, these guys are looking good. Oh, that was a nasty one. He had to readjust a little bit. It was way to the right. Not particularly a nice height. He dealt with it very well. And so did Andreas Macri. Three left then for these athletes. Pressure builds. And Glasnevich gives the impression of not feeling pressure. I'm sure he is. Macri focused. This may go the distance. Certainly just the two targets now. Before we get to our prescribed 35 out of 35, and so far, nothing between them. Nicely done. Didn't get it full square, but took a nibble out of the bottom left corner. That was a nice target to have when you're under pressure, not a problem. So then, one more target each. And now it is like a sudden death shoot-off. Whether we go to a sudden death shoot-off or not. hardly bear to watch, but they're going to have to. Now the pressure on Macri. Needs this one to take it to a shoot-off. And does. So, 32 apiece. Shoot-off it is. Well, this is an epic little battle between these two. 32 apiece. They embrace and then they go back into their little bubble of concentration. And we're about ready to go again. Helber with the bronze watching on like the rest of us. So it is Glasnevich. They were just waiting for the scoreboards to make sure it was Glasnevich going first. Puts the pressure on Macri. And he misses. He misses at the first shoot-off opportunity, but it is a silver medal and something for the home crowd to celebrate there. He takes the silver. And Anton Glasnevich it is who will take the gold. For Glasnevich, his third World Cup gold after wins in 2020 and 2021. Those are the three athletes. Well done to Andreas Macri as well. It's Mihalba who takes bronze, Macri with the silver, and Glasnevich, Anton Glasnevich with the gold.
Ladies and gentlemen, we move now to the award ceremony area, up in the cafeteria area.
Thank you.
tense finish, wasn't it? Not quite what the Cypriot fans were hoping for, but well, Anton, you'll be happy enough with a third gold for you now. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
How do you feel? It was a tense finish, wasn't it?
Yeah. Feeling was great because I tried so much to get to the final, and I have finals and semifinals, lots of, but without medals. So this is very, very, very grateful.
And of course, a difficult battle because you had to have a shoot off to get into the eight, and then yes. A shoot off, of course, at the end.
Yes, I shoot very well at the whole competition, but one target was missing all the time to get in the semi-final, and today I have shoot off before the semi-finals, and now after the finals I get also the shoot off.
And of course up against a local athlete, everyone I guess rooting for him. So is that extra pressure when you know that most people want the other guy to do well?
Yes, of course, but he's here in our country, so I know how it feels, because last year on the World Championship in Croatia, in Osijek, I feel like him. I know what they feel.
Look, I know you said a few questions because you want to go off and celebrate, so well
yes.
Done, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Hello to my family, to my friends. Goodbye.
There you go. The exit stage right. And we're done for here in Larnaca. There is the, of course, mixed team competition tomorrow, but that won't be televised. It will, of course, be on IWSF website. You can catch up with that. But we have lots going on during April. We'll be showing you the rifle and pistol from Lima. And, of course, Egypt. I'll be in Egypt at the end of the month for that as well. Thanks for your company. We'll see you next time.